Will it let it slip? From Team MV, this is Maru.
In the bottom left, it is Raynor.
To be on the defense, realizing he doesn't have enough at home, or potentially going to set up a flank here from both sides. In comes some Banelings, but they're streaming in single file. They bust through the Hellbats. The bio, though, still pretty healthy. The tank's getting some target fire on the cluster of Banes. Good target fire from Maru. The Banelings die, and that hatchery is still in trouble.
Big misengage from Raynor. His flank was not in position. He's going to go in again, but once again, mistiming the flank. The Lings and the Banes all coming in apart from each other. The Banelings getting focused down. Maru,
oh no,
massively outnumbered. Only barely is Raynor able to get rid of the tanks. This was an incredible engagement from Maru. Maru here in game five of this series. It felt like it started so bad. Raynor's got an insane work account, but if he loses this fifth base in the top left, which I think he will, a lot of those workers aren't really able to mine. So he's got a new base down to the bottom right, but the Banshees continue to be annoying down there. Finally, they're going to fall.
They are going to fall. It feels like Raynor, I mean, especially with this hatchery dying, just doesn't have the lava here. Like, does Maru need to go home? He's actually got such a big army. And even though there is a similar count here for the Zerg, the Marine survivor pull back. Not too many Banelings either. So he's going to turn a fire and target fire down. Two Mutalisks. Nice target fire there from Maru.
Yeah, really well done there. Punishing gets another Muta. The Mutas are finally going to get on top, but that boost should be ready. Another drop comes in on the left. How is Maru active on this map? There's Mutas and Massling Bane, and yet Maru's finding damage. I mean, Maru right now is doing very dangerous, very potentially ill-advisable moves. And Raynor, it's undefended. Go for it. And he does turn around. He goes for it, but it gives him a moment. And Maru uses that moment well, pulls the SCVs to safety.
Although they are getting made 3x3 at the moment with that reactive factory and the tech lab one.
Oh,
no, Maru not looking at the bio for a while there. The Banelings actually get a really good connection.
Very nicely done there by Raynor. 8 SCVs and a bunch of bio. More importantly, he's only attacking from one angle.
He's coming in with a lot of Ling Bane. The mines get a shot off there, but they don't actually get a critical connection on the Lings and the Banes. The Banes once again going for the SCV line. The Mute is assisting on the north side as well. Maru with a big concave of bio, though, and with the Thor surviving, he is still fine, but does take another blow to his SCV line. Does he feel like he needs to get out there and do something, or is he going to just slow the game down again and just get up to the late stages, get that Ghost Academy, and slow it way down? Oh, Raynor coming in with another wave of Banelings. Lots of Banelings here. The Winter Mines on the left side might be able to help out as the Banelings get close to that third. Actually looked like an all right high hold there from Maru, but in come more Banes. The Mutas on the top left actually getting shepherded by those Marines as well. And while Maru loses some more SCVs here, oh, I was going to say it looked like he held pretty well, but that last Baneling on those hurt SCVs. Muta's getting a little bit too close to that anti-air, though. Oh, man.
Oh, no. Oh, wow.
I don't know
if they just got F2'd or what, but those Mutas definitely met a nasty end. The Planetary does go down, Maynard. 7 workers with it. Raynor still has money to work with, or does he? Maru actually strikes across the map with a counter, takes a hatchery out.
He does indeed. While Raynor has a huge supply lead, it is all drones, Pig. It is not an army, and there is Terran army in his face and in his base right now. Two hatcheries going down within 10 seconds of each other, and it looks like even units on the right side. Raynor needs to split his army perfectly here. Not that many Banelings in the force, a lot of Marauders and Thors as well. Maru just lifts up, and he's going to go for the main. Oh no, Raynor falling apart at the seams. Another exposed hatchery with 26 drones on it. The Banelings too late to save it.
Oh my lord, he's knocked Raynor back to 4 bases, 3 of which are very low on resources. He's keeping Raynor off these 2 bases on the left. He gets another re-snipe on the hatchery. If Raynor doesn't build anti-air soon, he might be in trouble, Maynard.
He's going to have to rely very heavily on these ultras to take good fights, but the Marauder count of Maru is not too bad here on the defense. He's going to pull back, let the mines take some shots off on those giant units, and with the Marauders chasing, the ultras have to leave with a tail between their legs. 7 RCVs do die, but Maru does not care. He's still got a lot more units out on the map. Going to go for a denial on the hatchery again. In fact, a kill on that hatchery. Turns and fights the ultras. The ultras actually winning the fight there against the Marauders. The Liberator's a little bit too far forward. Looks like the mines might finish off an ultra here on the back end, though.
This is the sort of game which Raynor made a name for himself in. Scrappy down and dirty fights in multiple places. He has lost far too many hatcheries this game. This is big problems for Raynor. Maru's not going to stop pushing.
And it looks like Raynor just wants to get in his face and try that on for size. Can he get it done? And the north side, that base is in big trouble. But on the south side here, the hatchery also in trouble. Maru going to do more hatchery damage. Look at that 9th hatchery kill. The Planetary goes down. The SCVs go down. Raynor and Maru are just tearing each other apart from within.
But Maru's still got mules dropping on the right side. Raynor needs more than this. He's looking for it. He's hungry. He sees just a small pack of Marines and tanks. He goes in. I love the way he pulls the Lings back. Lets the Ultras deal with the big work there. But the rally will hold on. Raynor has to pull back for now. He's got no hatcheries. He's only got his third base mining. And I'll tell you, 17, 18 minutes in the game, the third base is barely mining. Raynor is trying to micro his heart out. But if he doesn't hatcheries right now, then he's screwed. He's got to rebuild those hatcheries, Maynard.
I don't know how he does it, Pig. He doesn't have the money. Maru is in charge here. The Mutas have come back just like he wanted, but there is not enough Zerg. I think there's too much Terran. I think Maru's got it here. He's going to bring in the reinforcements. Oh, no. A big hit on those Mutas.
He's
hit on those
Mutas,
but the Ultra's coming in.
This is still so close. He's going to get rid of this base.
Oh, wow.
Raynor, what was this the decisive move he needed? He gets rid of that base as well. Wait. He's killing all of Maru's mining right now. Was that actually the move he needed, Raynor? Maynard, this is crazy. What the hell? Is Raynor actually done it with that? Oh, Widow Mines. Oh, lots of
Widow Mines. And a turret as well. The Muta's not really fighting a whole lot. Oh, this hatchery, 20 drones at it. In come the Lings to pick off the Bio Army, but the hatchery does die. Maru lifts up what he can to save what he can. Oh, it's all about efficiency here. Oh, he's trying to try and hit the bottom right as well, but here are the
Ultras.
There's big fungals from Rayna.
Wow, that was monstrous. That's the first time he shows the Infestors. He's not going to get another chance. Maru was not expecting these Infestors. A lot of the medevacs went down. Four of them still very wounded there. They're going to be easy pickings in a future fight.
The Lings and Banes coming in the left side. Not that many mines anymore. And with a lot of Ling Bane and not any splash damage, they can definitely just roll through. This is an orbital, by the way, not a planetary, so it doesn't have fighting strength against this army of Rayna. The Bane is coming in. Really high energy Infestors coming in as well to drop those fungals. The split from Mario. A lot of the Marauders survive. The Banelings are gone. And the Infestors getting picked off as well. But does Rayna have enough to close this out?
Raynor's still got the base mining in the bottom right. He rebuilt his fourth, and that's mining as well.
Can he actually stop the Zerg force anymore? Widowmine's getting some shots off on the Ultras there, trying to keep the Mutas and the Infestors alive. Rayna trying to keep everything alive that he can. Force to lift up here at that orbital, though. Can't save that. Juice fungal on the Bio Army. A massive fungal there. The Ultras coming in for the cleanup. A lot of them will die, but there's not a whole lot of Marines. The Mutas coming in also to assist. Widowmine's underneath the force, though. Oh, no. Rayna losing a lot of that front line.
Ooh, the Lings, though. The Lings cracking into the natural at the same time. Maru's on his last legs. Is he taking efficient, valiant, defensive fights? Yes. Is it enough, though? I don't know. The Mutas go in. They get one of those Widow Mines. He wants to get those Liberators as well. The Lings still threatening. Ooh. This is an orbital. They're all orbitals. He knows that if there's no units, he can tear those worker lines apart. Raynor is going for the throat.
And he's bringing in the Lings now. These Lings have been doing damage, they've been biding their time, but now they are just biting Terran units. They're ripping them to shreds here at this base. The rest of the SCVs of Maru going down as well. Maru taps out. Rayna! Oh my god, he did it! The three games in a row against one of the greatest Terrans, potentially the greatest Terran alive. He did it here, and he is going to the grand final.
Holy crap. Hot damn. That was just... Oh my gosh, what a series.